On January 23rd, 6 days after Denise Amber Lee had been kidnapped from her home and brutally murdered, a funeral was held, the biggest the town had ever seen.
And she's my baby girl, and I'm going to miss her. I don't know how we're going to get on without her.
Hundreds of police officers came out to support the daughter of one of their own.
A 30-mile funeral procession. There's people put rose petals in the road. All the fire trucks are backed out of the fire station when the light's going. Elementary schools are out there standing there watching her go by. The people working on the side road was saluting the hearse.
Amidst the family's grief, the questions of Denise's ordeal that day still haunted them. Questions like, why did Michael King choose Denise in the first place? How could he have gotten her into his car?
He has a 95 green Camaro, and I have a 95 green Dodge Avenger. Anybody that knows cars knows that those cars look very similar. So, he could have pulled in the driveway, and she might have thought it was me, and then who knows what happened then.
And there was the question of those windows. Why had they been shut? Nate speculates it was one of Denise's final acts of motherhood, saving her children from a monster.
He could have shut the windows because he didn't want to hear her screaming, people hear her screaming, or she shut them.
So the kids could wander off.
Yeah, that would have been the first thing out of her mouth was, let me just make sure my kids are okay and make sure they don't get out.
The day of Denise's funeral, the police also got a lab report showing a match between King's DNA and DNA found on the wife and mother's body. In addition to kidnapping and murder, Michael King would also be charged with rape. King has since pleaded not guilty to all those charges. And there was more evidence in the back seat of that Camaro. Clues that the murdered detective's daughter may have intentionally left behind. Strands of her sandy brown hair torn out by the roots and stuck under the seat.
She knew they needed the root ball of the hair, huh?
You know, she used to love Law and Order, and she watched all those shows all the time.
Also, in the back seat of that car, they found the heart-shaped ring she always wore. The one Nate had bought for her on their first Valentine's Day.
You know, the ring didn't necessarily come off very easily, so it's not like it just fell off. Or I know she placed it there. And it's the only ring I know she would have been 100% I would have been able to identify, because that ring, it was the most sentimental thing I've ever, you know, it was just...
It was as though she was telling investigators, it was me, I was here.
What does that tell us about her?
Just to think that her going through all that she was still able to think of whatever she could do to, if case that she didn't get found. I'm sure she knew that, you know, my dad's doing everything he can. And he was.
Denise seemed to have done everything she could to save herself. But as Nate believes, the Charlotte County Sheriff's Office failed her. After the revelation of a missed 911 call, the county sheriff, John Davenport, was standing firm behind his decision not to fire his call center workers.
Those people, there's no punishment I could ever give them that they are not already facing themselves and living with themselves over all of this. They feel terrible about this. Terrible.
But if they choke under pressure, maybe they're not the right people. You still have confidence in that particular operator to receive calls.
I have total confidence in the people that have been involved in this. I truly do. And they've been under pressure many times before, but they didn't make the mistake. They did this time. We all have.
For Nate, that answer simply wouldn't cut it. He's now preparing a lawsuit against Charlotte County for negligence in his wife's death.
If you have heard Ms. Kowalski's call, you heard severe incompetence. That is unacceptable.
Lawsuits of this kind are typically capped at just $200,000. Nate says it's not about the money, but accountability.
Is that system that's in place today, Nate, and the people operating it, do you think they're complicit in your wife's murder?
I mean, I hate to say that the sheriff's office is responsible for my wife's death because, you know, they didn't pull the trigger, but they could have stopped him.
The potential lawsuit puts Nate's father-in-law, Rick Goff, in an awkward position since it's directed at the institution he's devoted his life to working for. But Rick has taken up a cause of his own, pressing for passage of a Florida law to standardize training for all call center workers. Last year, the Denise Amber Lee law was signed by the governor.
We had cars on the road waiting to apprehend the guy right where she was at. But they never dispatched the car. So, on behalf of my daughter, I'd like to see this bill passed.
And like I said, Denise had confidence in the system because that's why she dialed 911. And she's trying to get her life saved. And then Jane Kowalski, she had confidence in 911 that night, and she tried to get Denise saved, and that didn't happen. So, I don't know, that's all. We just want to instill confidence back in the system.
Is it tough for you to get your shoes and uniform on every day and drive over there and go to work?
I don't wear a uniform, but it was tough, you know, the first couple of days going back. People ask me every day, how you doing, how you doing? Well, I'm doing pretty crappy, to say the least. To me, there's no good day because she's not here. Some days are worse than others. Some days are all right, but there's no good days because she's not here.
Denise had done so many things right that day, leaving behind her own clues, secretly calling 911, screaming for help. But in the end, none of it was enough to save her and bring her back to her family.
Gotcha.
Nate, the boys, how are they doing? They're going to be too young to remember anything.
It's a blessing in some ways, but it's very unfortunate that they're not going to, you know, really have gotten to know her.
This face.
Okay.
But, you know, they're as healthy as can be, and I'm not worried about them. They've got part of Denise in them, and
you ready? Whoa!
That's the most comforting thing I can think about.
Oh my goodness!
What was that?
That went fast.